Vaughn was describing. I go, sounds really good. I'm gonna start with the shortest poem I've ever written, and it's real short. It is called Eating Mexican Food. Rule number one, don't pick up the tortilla with your fork. That's it.
Sanger High School students at the back. So they did
so I had the pleasure of having them on the cover of my book, which they stole immediately. That's another thing. So picture this. We have a nerd. His name is Martin, and he's fallen in love with this gang girl named Ceci. And there's a gangster wannabe by the name of Joaquin. And Joaquin has put his block on the wall in front of his school, which I don't want you to do. But anyhow, and the play is permissible. And Martin doesn't feel good about the circumstance he's in, because he likes his girl, and she does not like him. I'm going to read some lines from it. So Joaquin sees Martin. Hey, Martin, how come you're making la jeta, man, the long face? And Martin, the nerd, turns away. Come on, man, what's wrong with you, Holmes?
Nothing's wrong, I'm happy.
You ain't happy, man, what's with you, que pasó?
Really, I'm fine.
Let me guess, man, you didn't make the football team, is that right?
No, I didn't go out for football.
It's a joke, I say, man, I don't even go out for football. You had West Beam, oh, it's 7 or, oh, and 100 like the 49ers. Oh, I got it, man, your microscope broke out. And Martin wags his head no. You ran farm got sprayed with black flag, huh?
No, my ant farm is fine, and so is my goldfish, my hamster, Melvin. Man, ever since you and me first met in kindergarten, and I was there 2 years getting my colors down really good, you ran into the science stuff, man. I used to think that you're on the bottle, man, all stuck up, but no, I was wrong. You're just a nerd. I figure you're kind of people, nerds, and my kind of people, patos. We gotta come together. Yeah, I know what's wrong. Your calculator broke up.
No, my calculator works fine, but thank you for asking.
If I tell you, you won't laugh, will you?
And Joaquin feels a little sensitive toward his friend. He says, laugh? Laugh at the dude who helps me in biology? Who whispers in my ears and answers in algebra? Who fills me with history during finals? So what's going down?
It's my heart.
Tu corazón?
Yes, my corazón.
Love palpitations. Love palpitations. That's a hard one to fix. You sabes when you fool, the heart man is going down in Cabo. You gotta get inside a person to change things around. And sometimes, well, sometimes it's gotta be done.
You know how to repair a broken heart?
Simon, man, I'm the heart surgeon of all heart surgeons, man. Especially when it comes to romance. Shoot, last week I was on the phone with, actually it says Leonardo DiCaprio, but I'm going to change it to Justin Bieber. And Justin Bieber was all heartbroken, man. He was crying because his girl dumped him right in front of El Pollo Loco. Justin Bieber, he was crying? Yeah, man, the rain cloud. And then, as in play, you have sidekicks, minor characters. In this case, you have two tontos, and then Freddy and Tito. They come in. They come in. Mira, here comes Walter Canales and Freddy and Tito. And they yuck it up and do a very, really elaborate Rasa handshake. It takes about a half an hour to finish. Freddy speaking. Man, I got carpal tunnel syndrome from these handshakes, man. So what's going on, Joaquin? Joaquin. Unemployment, crime, blackism. Marty's broken heart. Freddy, Junior Einstein is heartbroken? Tito, when I saw his long face, and I thought his calculator was broke. Joaquin said, that's what I thought too, Holmes. They slap palms and do a couple of gestures. Tito to Joaquin, hey, guess what? Joaquin, walking, Tito. Hey, I don't know. Tito, Freddy found a part-time job. And Freddy smiles. Yeah, washing dishes at a Chinese restaurant, man. I'm gonna carry on the family tradition, man. Joaquin, man, seems like Rasa was born to wash dishes. So when did you start? Freddy, I started when I was 7 and my mom let me do the spoons and forks. No, tonto, when do you start the job? Oh, I don't start until this other bato gets fired. I'm next in La Nina, man. Joaquin, well, don't start right away because we have to help little Marty here, man.
You guys won't have to help me. I'll recover on my own.
Joaquin, Martin, you always help us in school with me, Freddy, Tito, and Young West. We're gonna see you through this really, really dark time of yours. Freddy, that's right, man. We can't let a homie down. Tito, man, you're the future leader of our people. Plus, we need the answer to next week's quiz, man. Smile, show a little teeth. teacher, but I kind of like my fourth grade teacher. This is one called Stars, and it's about, all of us have done this, where, you know, you read a book, you get a star, you can all write your name on the big list of things here. Star here, silver for nonfiction, gold for fiction, and I was love my stars. I would only read the back of the books. Stars. So one day, I came to school and found out this. For each book we read, we were allowed to paste stars next to our names. Gold for fiction, silver for nonfiction. I had mostly silver. Stories of frontier heroes, dead presidents in tall hats and nurses, banshee soldiers like mummies. In truth, I only read the back covers. If my teacher asked, well, what was it about? I said, well, it was about America. One day, six of my 14 stars were gone. My cosmic fate scratched off. The little light of my little body diminished, robbed of any chance to shine. I turned to my teacher, Mrs. Sloan. Had she pulled them off one by one? Or was there a star thief, a worse reader than me? I shivered when I saw Mrs. Sloan writing names on the chalkboard, mine and Steve Lopez's, who had once muttered shit in class at the assassination of President Kennedy. When I approached her, ready to confess, yeah, I sort of cheated, Mrs. Sloan. Mrs. Sloan slapped her hands of chalk dust and said, happy birthday. Then I understood. Steve Lopez and I were April birthday boys, cupcakes and a song for us, a phony paddling as we counted our years. Later, when I got up to sharpen a pencil for a math quiz, I tallied silver and gold stars and fumed at Steve Lopez's uncountable rows of shooting stars, some barely hanging off by his awful skit. He, Steve Lopez, was the star of me. I ground my teeth at the thought. We were born the same month, the same year, skinny from rickets, bad at fractions and writing, an early elimination of the rainy day spelling bees. But Steve had flunked third grade, was a year older. We lived in the same street, owned dogs and walked like old men, and cowered under the beatings of mean mothers. I knew Steve Lopez had no starry light inside him. Idiot boy. He came in balancing three books on his blockhead. When he tripped and fell, I imagined stars behind his eyes, all bloody red, not pretty, pretty silver.